I notice she's trying to get close to you, and I don't understand why she's doing that.
Gara, all this time I've been helping her because she's your sister.
You know what? I don't want to think that she's trying to destroy our relationship, but that's how I feel about
it. Gara, I assure you, Sara can't do anything to tear us apart. Trust me.
I know you're mad at me, Sara, but even if you won't believe me, I love you. I can give everything to you, but I'm begging you, please don't take Seb, not him.
Shmael?
Laura?
There's someone outside.
What?
There's a man standing outside staring at me.
Hey, you look like you didn't sleep well. Are you the one with the hangover?
I'll be frank with you. That act of yours isn't going to work with me. You might be a good actress, but I'm not stupid.
Between the two of us, who's the first one who did this?
I'm willing to share everything I have with you, just not Seb.
I just brought the things of Sara.
Can we talk about this first? What's wrong with you? I was drunk, I was irrational.
I know that you know what you were doing. I'm not stupid. It's best if we stay away from each other for now.
Finally, this is where I'll stay. I'll make a good living and be happy.
I want us to be partners.
I have a better proposition for you. Why don't you sell us De La Rosa Builders?
The answer is no. I will never sell the company Antonio and I worked so hard to build.
Cara, I know that everything that's happened has confused you. But if there's one thing I don't want you to doubt, it's my love for you. I won't let myself hurt you anymore. I love you so much.
Wedding anniversary.
Surprise!
I'll never love another man the way that I love you.
We've become stronger. We've never given up on each other. Happy anniversary.
What about my presents?
Not that, man. We're about to deliver it.
What I want is to personally give my gifts to Laura and Ishmael.
Honestly, I want a man who's handsome, kind, and who loves you for who you are. And of course, someone who can bear with me. Will give me his unconditional love. An intense kind of love.
Honestly, this anniversary party is so wonderful. You know what? All that's missing is the presence of the president.
Hold on a second. Who told you that the president wasn't here?
Oh, yeah. Ishmael, don't joke around. The president's here and I didn't wear my best dress.
He's right there. I'll call him for you.
Philip!
Ishmael! See that?
Who's that?
He's the president of the Association of the Taxi Drivers.
Oh,
I got you there.
I thought you were actually serious.
Just kidding.
You know what, Mother, Father, I'm so happy right now. And the smiles on your faces make things even better.
Kara, you have no idea how happy you've made your mother and me, too. Thank you for that.
Thank you, Kara. To both you and your sister, and to all of you who helped in tonight's event, I'll never forget this. I've never experienced a celebration like this before.
Tell me about it. Oh, did you know? Just imagine this. When your parents got married back then, right? All we had to serve was fried noodles.
Oh, we had more than that. We had rice cakes,
oh,
too.
Oh, right.
And we even had some day-old orange juice. It was so bland.
You know what, you guys? We should do this every year. After all, the two of you deserve it.
Aww,
that's so sweet.
Great. It's too expensive.
Of course not, compared to everything that you two have done for Sara and me. This is the absolute least we could do. Think of it as our way of saying
you're
things.
You're such a sweetheart,
Thank you so
Kara.
Much, Kara.
Madam, dinner is served.
Has Lucille come home yet? I've been calling her for a while now, but she isn't answering my calls.
Well, if she's not home, perhaps she's still in the office. She has become really busy lately. And I have heard rumors that the company is in really deep waters.
Honestly, Anita, I know my daughter. She doesn't need to tell me, but I know that she's going through something. If she has a problem, she won't give up so easily. And she will just keep on going until she gets what she wants.
Madam, can she really take it? I worry for her. Every so often I see her sitting in silence and deep in thought. Madam, should I call Lucille's driver?
No need, Anita. I'll do it.
Hello, Ma'am Barbara?
Yes. Are you with my daughter, Lucille?
Yes, ma'am, I am.
Are you still at the office?
No, ma'am.
Then where are you?
Answer me, where are you?
Ma'am Barbara, your daughter's in Quezon City. It seems Ma'am Lucille is attending a party.
What party?
That's all I know, ma'am. Oh, but I did see Ma'am Kara here earlier.
Which location?
Excuse me, I have some stuff to
Okay, don't let us keep
right.
you.
Kara?
Oh,
sorry.
Well, anyway, I think I'm gonna go look for that.
Hey, wait a second.
Yeah.
You do know I'm sorry, don't you?
I'll be right here.
I was really drunk, so give me a break, will you?
I know.
Okay, Now don't panic. I promise I'm not drunk right now, all right?
How about later?
For crying out loud, I'm not having any alcohol. Are you happy now? So, Seb, can you forgive me for what I've done?
You know, Sara, there's no need for that. I'm not mad at you.
Is that right? Well, why didn't you say so? Then I guess we're all good. Give me five.
But I don't want to hurt Kara. Believe it or not, Kara is so affected by all of this. She's doing everything she can so you won't fight. And I don't want to get in the middle. I am doing this for Kara. I hope you understand.
All right, I understand. You know you talk too much.
Wait! Oh no, I almost forgot! You need to say something! Oh, good grief! Hold on, hold on! hello? Oh, there. Hello! Goodness, I almost forgot! Of course, dear guests, we also need to call on my two goddaughters! Laura and Ishmael's two loving daughters! The most beautiful twins in the whole country! Kara and Sara! Come on up here, girls! Just say a few words to everyone. Come on.
All right.
Oh, there.
I would like to thank everyone here for giving us a bit of your time to join us in celebrating this very special evening commemorating the anniversary of our parents, Laura and Ishmael. Mother, Father, I know we've been apart for a long time. So I just want to let you know that every single day from now on, I'll dedicate myself to your happiness. Thank you so much for loving me and my sister, Sara. She and I will always be here for you. And we both love you so much. Happy anniversary.
Aww. Woo. Thank you, my darling Kara. And of course, my other goddaughter, the beauty queen. My beautiful, darling goddaughter, Sara.
Hi. Good evening, everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, to those who don't know me, I'm Sara. Mother, Father, happy anniversary. I hope you have many more to come and more power for you both. Oh, wow. How do I say this? I know I've been a handful because I'm just so beautiful, but you already know that. But thank you for being patient, for always standing up for me. And for your love, thank you. I know I don't always say this to you, but I love you both very much. Happy anniversary. I thank you.
Wow. Wow. She's a firecracker, isn't she? Oh, gosh. And of course, something new. Let's call our two lovebirds to take the floor, my dear Laura and Ishmael, and continue things with a little intimate dance. Come on.
Wait a minute. I don't even know how to dance, Itoy.
It won't take long. Don't you want to see them dance?
Dance.
Don't be shy. This won't take long. And aside from the dance, listen, everyone.
Sweet.
They'll be serenaded by their future son-in-law, Sam.
Come on.
Padama sa iyong totoo.
Sam, what happened?
What's going on?
Why'd the music stop?
Where'd that come from?
Well, well, well.
Oh, wow.
What a beautiful celebration we have here. Happy wedding anniversary, Laura and Ishmael. You know, it seems that you've forgotten someone, because I didn't get an invitation. Am I not a member of this family too? Remember back in the day when you imposed your presence onto our family? And then destroyed my marriage until my husband died? And now, You're celebrating your wedding anniversary without inviting me. I'm really hurt, you know.
You weren't invited because you caused trouble.
Laura, please, have some manners for once. Is that any way to treat your guests? Tell me.
You aren't a guest, Lucille.
All right, relax. I promise I won't be long. I just came to drop off this present I got for you.
We don't want anything from you.
Oh, come on, Ishmael. It's really not a big deal, so just take it. Excuse me, do you mind? Oh, you can open it. And besides, it is bad luck to refuse a gift, am I right?
Is this a sick joke? It's a wedding anniversary, and your gift is a memorial plan?
Wait, 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 there's more.
Oh, Lucille, you are sick!
What's happening? What is she doing?
Well,
is this some kind
do you like
of joke
my presents? What is she doing? Those are his and hers. You know, it's all the rage right now. And I'm pretty sure this isn't something you've planned for. I mean, obviously, you never really know when it's your time to go, am I right, guys? And that's why it's best that you're all prepared and that you each have coffins of your own. Not to mention your own service, with flower arrangements as well as food. And you'll also have options. You can be buried or cremated, it's all up to you. I just think it's a perfect gift for you. And the best part is it's all paid for. I just hope that someone gets to use it very soon.
Move it! Now you listen to me, you better get out of here before I beat you up!
Hold on a minute. Why do you seem so jealous, Sarah? Don't worry, because when your time comes, I'll send you a present as well. But it'll be a carpet to wrap your body in when you're gone.
Why, you shameless hack! If you don't leave now, I'm going to bury you alive! Get out! Get out of here if you don't want to get hurt!
But didn't you guys like my gifts at all?
Please leave.
Hey, wait, I'm hardly
get
done.
Get that woman out of my sight!
Please take care of Sarah.
Come here, dear.
Are you happy now that you've ruined the celebration? Just go, would you?
Kara?
Take those out! Take them out, I say!
You stay right here.
I'm not leaving here that easily. Because whatever you do, I will always be a part of your life, and there is nothing you can do about that.
Mommy, that's enough. What more do you want?
We have been minding our own business since you won the case. And now you don't even have to pay for what you did to us, so could you please stop this? Why don't you just go and leave us in peace?
Take those away!
Wait a sec. Where are you taking the coffins? Kara! Kara, it's your family who had wronged me! They're the reason our family was destroyed, and that's why I won't stop until you and I are together again!
Lucille, stop!
Will you please? That's enough. You can't bring back the family you've lost, especially when your heart is filled with hatred. All right, tell me, who would want to be with someone like you?
What did you just say? How dare you? You ungrateful wretch!
Now that's enough! I told you to get out of here! Get out!
Hey! Ow. Let me go!
Lucille!
Let me go!
Lucille!
Grandma, get her out of here before things get really out of control!
Let's go, Lucille.
Tell me, do you really think that this is the end? It's not! Not by a long shot! Kara, I'm sure you know you owe your life to me. Every breath you take is a breath you owe me, which is why you are mine! You're mine, Kara!
Let's
go! And I'm taking you back no matter what, and you had best remember
that! Now get out!
We need to go now, Lucille. Please.
You remember that!
Oh my. Excuse me. Oh my goodness. Hello everyone. I'm so sorry about all that. Let's all ignore any attention seekers since they're crazy. So instead, let's just it's party time. Music, please. Woo! Let's dance. Everyone find a partner. Let's dance the night away. Come on, find a partner. Come on, you all! Find a partner! Let's start dancing! Let's go! Oh, careful.
Let me take
oh,
that.
Thank you, and the gifts,
it's
too.
It's all right, I've got them.
Okay, let me and Andy arrange those. Oh, Andy, switch those lights on, please.
Okay, I got it.
Are you all right, Kara?
She just won't stop, that Lucille.
please, Laura and Ishmael, just forget about what that crazy woman did at your wedding anniversary party earlier, okay? Just think of the fun moments, the happy ones. We made some good memories there.
Lucille, wait.
Mom, it's not like I've done anything bad. All I did was deliver them presents that they would never forget. There's nothing wrong with that. It's not illegal. I haven't done anything wrong at all.
I get it. You want revenge, but not this way. You're just inviting more trouble. What you did was self-incriminating. They can file another case against you because of that.
I don't care about that, Mom. I don't care if I have to face them 100 times in court. I will not allow them to be happy, you hear?
Why don't you get some rest, guys? I'm sure this will all be over in the morning.
Laura, no matter what Lucille throws at us, we won't let her get away with it.
Mother, stop thinking about it. It won't happen again. And for whatever it's worth, I'm going to be right here by your side to make sure you're all right. I'll make sure everyone's all right.
She's right, Mom. Don't worry. I'll also be taking some actions. I'm going to look for a way to get legal protection so this doesn't happen again.
I won't allow them to be happy, Mom. Especially now. They're celebrating their wedding anniversary? It's Antonio and I who should be celebrating. I should be the one celebrating my wedding anniversary with my husband, but I'm not. And I can never do that again because Antonio is gone. It's entirely their fault that I'm suffering now. It's entirely their fault that I'm hurting every single day. And it's entirely their fault that I'm suffering from so much pain right now. And that is why I cannot allow them to be happy. That family cannot have a happily ever after.
Lucille.
I can't allow that family to be happy, Mom.
You know, Kara, you're right. We have to course this through legal procedures. Want me to come with you meet the lawyer? Are you sure about that? All right, then. Just let me know, okay? Okay.
Hey, Seb. Why a lawyer? I thought you came from the Suarez's anniversary.
And it just so happens, they now need a restraining order against Lucille.
What? But why? What happened?
Well, Lucille crashed the anniversary party of the Suarez's to cause trouble. And that was the last straw for Kara. She is not going to allow that woman to go near them again. Lucille's just getting too dangerous.
I guess the wheels do turn. One day you're wallowing in the mud, and the next you're up in the heavens.
What did you say? Now, what did you mean by that?
Nothing at all. It's just Lucille, all right. That woman is nothing but bad luck. And that's why if the Suarez's want better days ahead, they should stay away from Lucille as much as they can.
Attorney, do we have a case to file? Is that enough to get a restraining order against her?
That shouldn't be a problem at all. First of all, there was a verbal death threat. Second to that, we have photographic evidence to support it. And thirdly, we are also in possession of the witnesses' accounts.
I really hate to admit it, but it is true that Mommy threatened us. And I'm sure that she meant it too. I know my mom, attorney. And she's capable of carrying out those threats.
I understand what you're saying. Which is why what we have to do now is head to the prosecutor's office and file charges of grave threat against her. And after that, we can head straight to family court, which is where we can file for ex parte petition for the issuance of a temporary restraining order. And that can be done within 24 hours.
Is that so? Attorney, we really need your help. We need that restraining order as soon as possible.
Don't worry, Kara. I will do everything in my power to get you that order.
I would really appreciate that.
So, Kara, how have you been?
Oh, I'm all right. As you know, the restraining order I filed against Mommy is pending, and that is enough for my family to look forward to.
Well, that's good to hear. When that's done, Lucille can't do anything more to harm you all.
That's right. I'm still sad, though. I really wanted that night to be special for Mother and Father.
God, I'm sure it was. And I'm sure that they were grateful for that. Kara, you did an amazing job, okay? You know, I hope that when we get married, I hope our reception would be that great as well.
Have I ever told you that I want my wedding to be as simple as possible? Intimate but classy. I don't want one with too much fuss and frills. I don't want to be like those brides who are so stressed out during their wedding day.
Kara, on our wedding day, you'll have no reason to be anxious. I want you to be pampered. I want you to be pampered, relaxed, free from stress, and all hassles. You'll be the queen. My queen.
Mm-hmm. The super boyfriend strikes again.
I refuse to be part of this company's downfall.
You are a quitter!
Say whatever it is you want to say, but I have made my decision.
Oh.
What's this commotion all about?
Lucille, I'm so glad that you finally arrived. Let me not beat around the bush here. I'm going to sell my company shares.
What? And why is that?
We're all in this mess because of you. And I won't allow myself to be part of your downfall.
Get out. All of you, get out of this room!
Okay.
All right.
It's ready
you
now.
You two, you need to eat. Hey, Andy. Go wake Sarah up so we can all have breakfast together.
I woke her up a while ago. She said she'd like to sleep more because she hasn't slept well.
I understand. Thank you so much.
Kara, who's that on the phone?
Oh, that was the lawyer, Father. He says we'll be getting the restraining order against Mommy today.
Oh.
Restraining order? Does that mean Lucille can't approach us anymore?
Yes, Mother. I would do anything to make sure she doesn't hurt you again. Besides, I'm sure Mommy would never stop hounding us. Not long ago, I was hoping that we could sort things out, but given the current situation, I don't think we can anymore.
All right, start eating, dear. Andy, hurry up!
All right, I'm sorry. Here you go.
Excuse me, ma'am. Someone is asking for you.
Send him in, please.
Yes, ma'am. Sir, she'll see you now.
Mrs. Lucille De La Rosa?
Yes, that's me.
A restraining order was filed against you, and now you're prohibited to go near or contact the family of Ismael and Laura Suarez.
Hey, Sarah's awake.
Sarah,
good morning, Princess Sarah.
Join us, dear. Will you be working today?
No, I'm not.
Why
not?
Surprised. You've been absent for 3 days.
I just don't feel like it. And besides, I did tell you that I wasn't going to leave you alone, and that I'd defend you against Lucille, so I'm staying home.
You don't have to worry about that anymore. We now have a restraining order against Mommy.
Do you really think that would be enough?
I think we don't need to worry about Lucille anymore. We'll be fine, dear. So it's okay. How are your studies going? Don't you have an exam today?
Well, I'm not so sure I want to go back.
What?
What? Didn't you want to finish your studies? It would be such a shame if you didn't pass.
Well, that's the plan, Mother, and everything was on track. The thing is, some people didn't have faith in me, so I just lost my initiative.
Try not to think about what's troubling you. If it's Lucille, forget about her. The Sarah I know doesn't just give up easily. The Sarah I know is a fighter.
You're
what
right.
happened to her?
She's right, Sarah.
And Sarah, just relax. If it's Lucille you're worried about, forget about it. I'll take care of things here. And I'll keep Aunt Laura company. So go ahead, eat your breakfast, have a nice shower, and put on your best dress, and get ready for class.
I'm glad you're back in class. I trust that Mrs. Baluyot wasn't hard on you?
I got a mouthful, but I got the chance to explain what's been happening lately. At least she gets where I'm coming from.
You know, Sara, some people would be willing to understand you. If you would just try not to push them away and change for the better.
Listen up, Seb. I do want to change for the better, but whenever I try to change my ways and become a whole different person, all those people willing to help me are suddenly gone.
That's not true.
That's not true? Well, then I dare you to prove it. And give me a second chance. Because after all, you're really the only one I know who can help me with these exams, all right? And I can't do this alone.
I can help you with that. But not directly. I can find you a good tutor to help you.
A tutor?
Someone that can help and handle you.
Now hold that thought, Seb. Just wait here, okay?
Hello, Sara. Where are you at?
Well, I'm at work. Why do you ask?
Didn't you know? Edward is leaving today.
What? Where is he? Is he right there? May I speak with him? Could you please put him on the phone?
Oh, I'm afraid not. They boarded the plane some time ago, and the plane just left the tarmac.
Sara? Hey, Sara, are you all right?
No, Edward's gone abroad. And I didn't get the chance to say goodbye.
I'm going to prove to Mom that I'm straight when it comes to work. Hello, how is everything? I need you to do your job as planned. Although there is something else that I would need you to do.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Let me close it.
Thank you.
Let's go.
I think I'll sit up front with you.
What is that?
I really don't think of you as my driver, Ishmael. You're considered a friend. And in any case, it would make chatting so much easier.
But it's not comfortable up front. The back seat's much better.
That's fine.
Let me get the door. Okay, then.
Amazing! Hey, you know, I just thought about this. Should you ever consider changing careers, you should give organizing events a shot. Why not, right? I mean, you're a natural after all. Have you posted those on social media? Because this will go viral, Kara, for sure.
Oh, Camille Rose, you're way too kind.
These are great. They're just... Oh, hello,
ma'am. Can I see the photos?
Oh, but of course.
No, 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 it's okay. Sit down, sit down.
They're great, aren't they? Kara, she has talent. Mm-hmm. She has more photos in her laptop as well.
They're very simple, but... classy and elegant.
Thank you Beautiful. So much for saying so.
I trust that you slept well last night. I hope nobody bothered you.
I slept well.
That's good to hear.
Oh, before I forget, I brought you a thank you gift.
What?
Well, I was preparing myself some food and I thought I'd pack a little more so that we could share.
You didn't have to do that, but thanks.
Oh, please don't worry about it. This is my favorite. I hope you like it. Carbonara.
Hey, that's one of my daughter's favorites, too.
Is that right? Nice. I'm sure that your daughter will love my version. Haven't I told you before? This is my specialty, you know. Check it out.
Ooh, that smells really great.
You know what, Kara? My fiancé is opening his company soon. Actually, very, very soon. See, he is the founder of this website company. He created an app for home and office improvements. And he has plans to put up a launching event. And we're in the cramming stage right now because of his limited time here in the Philippines. And that's stressing me out.
You know, Miss O, you don't have to be stressed. Our solution for that is Kara!
Camille Rose!
My thoughts exactly. I would really appreciate it if you can help me, Kara.
Miss O, I would really like to help. It's just that I don't have a lot of experience with events.
Kara, I believe in you. I know you can pull this off. And by looking at these pictures, I know you'll do a great job.
Thank you, Miss O.
Is that a yes?
Yes.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yes!
Ishmael, tell me something. How many kids do you have now? What do they do? Aside from carbonara, what else do your children like to eat?
I have two children. Both girls, and they're twins. One of them likes carbonara, and the other one is crazy about pasta a la ketchup. And although they may be twins, but they couldn't be more different because one of the girls grew up in America, while the other one grew up with our family.
Sounds like your twins are interesting people. I hope that I can meet them one day.
Well, that's not a bad idea at all.
Do you mean that?
Sure.
You know, Ishmael, I would really appreciate it. The truth is, I don't really know a lot of people aside from the ones I work with. You see, I just moved to the city and it would be nice to get a chance to know a couple of more people. I'm so lucky to have met you, Ishmael. I'm sure your girls are just as nice as you.
Flirt.
Wait a second, what is your problem?
It's a good thing I went to see my brother. Otherwise, I wouldn't know how much you've latched onto him.
Will you wait a second? You're not just a traitor, but you're obnoxious as well. Don't you have a decent bone in your body?
Give me a break, Sarah, because I'm not stupid. I know what you're trying to do, so just stay away from my brother.
I understand what this is all about. You're looking for trouble. That's what you want, right? All right, Alex. I'll give you trouble. Oh. What?
Get off of me, you shameless hag!
Did you have manners
right
with?
Now?
How dare you call me shameless? Come here, I'm going to beat you unless you'll never forget. How dare you call me a shameless hag? Get out of my sight
now!
You don't even know what you're saying. You just can't stand the fact that this is all your fault.
I've done nothing to you. How many times do I have to say that? And if you have a problem with me, just leave my brother out of it. Stay away from Seth.
My goodness! What if I told you that your suspicions were right? I'm sorry, Alex, but you're a little late there. And besides, you owe me $9 million. So why can't your brother be payment for what you owe me, huh?
You really are a shameless witch. I won't allow it. And you better stay away from Seth, because if you don't, I'm going to tell Kara everything.
You'll tell Kara? Oh, I'm scared. I'm absolutely terrified, petrified, horrified. Oh, please don't tell Kara.
You should be scared, because when I tell her everything that I know, you'll be out in the streets.
Oh, yeah? Come on. Give it your best shot. But you'll be wasting your time because nobody is going to listen to you. You know, Alex, you and Kara are the same. Neither of you can seem to stand the fact of me being with Seb. Are you that intimidated by my beauty, Alex?
Wow. Wow, I'm so sorry, Sarah. I didn't know you were delusional. Leave my brother alone. This is your final warning.
Oh, yeah? Well, then give me back my $9 million and stop spewing out empty threats. What? You want to fight? Come on, let's fight. I thought you were tough, Alex.
Let me go. I said I'm done here. We're not done. Not by a long shot.
We're not even close. Let go of me, will you? That's right, walk away!
I
Mama,
am back.
Those look heavy. Let me help you with that, dear.
Oh, thank you, Itoy. Mother.
Oh, you went shopping?
I just needed to buy some stuff. The thing is, I saw Miss O earlier, and she mentioned that she really liked what I did with the anniversary party I set up for you. So now she wants me to manage the launch party for the company that her fiancé is setting up.
What? Is that a part of your job, darling?
Actually, it's not, but she did say she was going to pay me separately. And the truth is, I couldn't say no because I've received nothing but support from Miss O.
That means she likes Kara's work.
Seems so.
You're not wrong there. But I do have a problem, though. Given that I'm already strapped for time and I still have to sort out a lot of details, especially the flower arrangements, because most shops can't handle that kind of event. Forget about what little time I was given.
Flowers? Don't be silly, Kara. Your mother here used to sell flowers.
What?
You know
what
someone who does arrangements for things like parades, for feasts, for funerals,
right.
And even for festivals, right?
Festivals, yes. Last I heard, they had their own farm. I still know the number. I'll call them up.
That would be really great. I'd appreciate your help on this.
You're
one.
You're welcome.
See? Lucille.
Why are you outside my house?
You still owe me, remember? I want my money right now.
Have you completely lost your mind, Alex? If my mom sees you right now, then you will definitely not get any money from me.
Well, that's not my problem, Lucille. You and I had a deal, and I want my money now, so hand it over.
Are you kidding? Why don't you just get out of here, will you?
Don't touch me!
You should go before my mom sees you out here!
I don't care about that! Give me what you owe me or else!
You have to leave!
I told you not to touch me!
Just get out of here!
Not until I get my
money! Alex! What are you doing here?
Hey, Mother, if you don't mind, I could really use your help on this one, because it's just me and Camille Rose right now.
Sure, dear. Just let me know what I have to do, Kara. I'll help you.
Thanks a lot, Mother.
Oh, don't worry, because Andy and I will help you too, Kara.
That would be really great.
Hey, count me in. I want to help too.
Seb.
Good morning, you two.
Hello, good morning, Seb. To you too, Seb.
Anyway, how can I help you?
Actually, Miss O just asked me to organize an event for her fiancé's company.
Well, I'm sure you'll do a great job. I mean, after seeing what you did for your parents' anniversary party...
I sure hope you're right. And I do have you guys.
You know what, Alex? You should really leave, and I'll call you when I can.
Wait, why are you insisting me to go? Who do you think you are, huh? Don't tell me you've forgotten already that I hold your fate in my hands, Lucille. I came here to collect, and I suggest you pay up.
My daughter doesn't owe you anything!
I wasn't talking to you, was I? I'm not here for you, so mind your own business while I talk to your daughter, Lucille!
You're as disrespectful as your mother, aren't you?
Don't you dare bring up my mother right now!
And why? Wasn't she? Wasn't she just a gold-digging mistress? And now, you're a gold-digging bastard!
No, you take that back!
That's enough! Please, Alex,
hey,
just get out of here!
Go.
Get out of here!
Get out of my property!
Lucille, tell your mother to shut it, will you? I just can't stand her. You don't want to make me angry, because let me remind you, Lucille, you had me kidnapped, and your mother, Barbara, was your accomplice. Now, how would you like it if I called the cops and bring both of you behind bars?
Don't you dare threaten us!
I guess what they say is true. The apple doesn't fall too far from the tree. I mean, just take a look at your daughter. She's angry and heartless, just like her mother.
You really are shameless!
You
Alex! Alex, stop it! Huh? I said stop it, Alex! Mom, go inside, will you? I'll take care of this. Go ahead. Go inside. Alex, that is enough, all right?
I'm not leaving here until you pay your debt in full. Now cough it up!
Madam, was that Alex screaming outside?
Yes.
Well, what did she want?
The same thing as before. Their inheritance. That woman is so ambitious and money-hungry.
Alex will never give up until she gets what she wants.
And neither will I. If she thinks that I will easily give up, she's absolutely mistaken. She will never see a cent of my family's money.
And your mother should be grateful, Lucille. Grateful that she's old, or I wouldn't have held back. If she was younger, who knows what I would have done. But I can promise you this much. That was the last time she will ever lay a hand on me.
Alex, just stop it. Stop being so overdramatic. You deserve that.
That's enough. I only came here to get the money that I'm due. So would you just give me my cash so I can go?
Are you really asking me for money again? Didn't I just pay you off? What am I paying you for now?
The money's for Seb.
Madam Barbara, I'm not trying to tell you what to do. But wouldn't it be much easier if... if you and Lucille just give them the money, then everybody would be at peace. Didn't you say that you wanted Lucille to be better? Well, if that's the truth, then shouldn't you lead by example? How will Lucille even get better if all she sees is her own mother full of rage?
I'm different, and so is Lucille. I carefully think before I do something.
And now your brother wants money as well?
He doesn't, because he's not involved at all. I'm just trying to keep him away from Kara. What I want is for them to be out of our lives. And I want everything to be like it was before. Because we were happy back then, when we were still a family. I want back the life that your mother destroyed. That is what I want.
Well, then you'll have to wait. I'm having problems with the company, and I can't just take cash out of the vault.
That's not my problem, Lucille. Just give me the money that you owe me. I'm giving you 1 week to pay up. If you don't, I'll collect in a different way. And it won't just be your company going down, because you will be rotting behind bars.
Lucille is too impulsive. She needs to be protected. How can I find it in my heart to forgive them? They ruined my family! Lucille is the only one I have left in my life, and I will do everything just to be able to protect her. And I need to ensure her safety.
Alex, could we just stop threatening each other? Shouldn't we be seeing each other as allies? I mean, we both want the same thing, right? And that is for the Suarez family to disappear from our lives.
Come on, I'll cook you dinner.
I'll just have some of this food I brought home.
What is it?
It's carbonara, given by my passenger.
That's Kara's favorite.
I know. I'll save some for her.
Wait, that was pretty nice of them.
Yes, she is. I guess she's just showing her gratitude for the help that I gave her. Hey, you know, while we were talking, I felt some pity for her. The thing is, she's all alone. Her parents are gone, and she doesn't have anyone.
I'm glad that she found a friend in you.
As far as I can tell, what she really needs is family and friends. Given all that she's going through. Oh, that's enough.
Huh? Aren't you hungry?
All right, okay.
Thank you.
Just get some more later.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Oh, hi, Mom.
You're late. Don't tell me you gave in to the demand of that bastard woman.
Mom, you should not have confronted Alex the way that you did. Let's not provoke her.
So you will just give her whatever she wants, is that it? Is that why you gave her money? She's playing you for a fool, and your company's going down too.
That's enough, Mom. Do you think that I'm stupid or something? I'm simply indulging Alex right now so I wouldn't have to worry about her. Mom, please, stop meddling with things that have nothing to do with you.
But your strategy is ineffective. If you don't find a way to control Alex soon, she will keep on taking advantage of you.
I can't see. The screen goes dark too
fast.
You've
come home late.
Oh.
That's because we had to do inventory. I've been counting all day. I thought my head would explode.
We just had dinner. Have you eaten yet?
Actually, I haven't, and the truth is I'm starving.
Well, come on, join us. There's some carbonara left.
Sit down. I'll get you food.
Father, you know, I don't like my job at all, and working at a place like that is surely not my life's ambition.
Hey, Sarah, isn't that why you're in school?
Oh, I don't know, Andy. I've just really lost the taste for studying.
But that's such a waste.
Well, Father, it doesn't really matter, because there's no way I'm passing school.
No, why would you say that? I mean, aren't you being tutored by Seb?
Mom, that's enough. I don't want to argue with you, so just leave Alex alone. And I'd appreciate it if you stopped meddling with my life choices, all right?
I'm just warning you, Lucille. With what's happening now, it looks like you're just bringing more trouble into your life, which might cause your downfall.
You know what? I started noticing this since yesterday. Like you're ignoring each other. Are you two fighting again?
No, we're not.
I'm sure there's someone else who could tutor Sarah.
Hey, you know, that's just too bad, because I can only really learn things when you're my tutor. Oh, come on, Kara. I really don't think you want me to fail at school. What? Are you at a loss for words?
It's because I'm not the one you should ask. Seb is. He's the one with a schedule to keep.
Oh, I'm sure he could take a little time off his schedule for a good cause.
All right. You win.
Really? Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Seb. Let's trade skeds later, huh?
Eat up, dear.
Yes, ma'am?
I want to see Mr. Santos.
Of course, ma'am. I'll let him know when he gets back.
Where is he anyway?
Well, ma'am, his secretary said that he was meeting with the executives and the shareholders. They've been in conference since this morning. It was scheduled rather early.
And why wasn't I informed? Why didn't I get a notice? Isn't that your job, Stella?
Sorry, ma'am, but I wasn't informed either. No one said you were supposed to be at this meeting.
And why shouldn't I be in that meeting? Didn't you say the executives were there? What do you think I am, huh? I'm the owner of this company, so why wasn't I informed? What exactly is their agenda?
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I really wouldn't know that.
Go on then.
Seb!
I'm really glad you came. I'm dying to learn something. How about we get started, huh?
All right, then. So those books I lent you, have you read them?
Of course I have. I'm so ready right now.
Great. Let's get started.
Okay. Seb.
Kara.
Kara, what are you doing here?
Well, she's with me. Is there a problem here?
Problem? Not at all.
Don't worry, Sara. I won't be bothering you. I'm just here to write my report.
Oh, is that right?
Hey, do you have plans after this? I mean, you're all dolled up and everything.
Dolled up? No, I have no plans. Oh, come on, Kara. You should be used to me by now. I'm always like this, dolled up. Government of the people, by the people, for the people. Seb, would you mind checking my work? Start with this one.
Which one?
That one. Number one. Is it right?
Afraid not.
It's wrong?
I thought you studied.
May I take a look? Seb is right. You should start with this sentence for this paragraph. That's what you got wrong.
Oh, is that so? I'm sorry, Kara. I'm not as intelligent as you.
Sara, I was just trying to help, all right?
I know that. Why do you think I apologized in the first place? I apologized because I know that teaching me must be such a pain. You know, all of this studying, I really find it difficult. You should know that. Which is why you should tutor me, Seb. Because Kara here is not even a real teacher. Not like you, anyway. So you'll have more patience with
me. Okay, fine. Let's just concentrate, okay?
Okay. Seb, do you see that look? She's getting annoyed. Take a look.
I'll put this here.
I'm just fine.
This one's good.
That one? I got it right?
You did.
I guess I am learning.